What's up, guys? Of course, welcome to another Pokemon Wi-Fi battle with yours truly, the Scavenger. And today we're going against Codron, otherwise known as Deranged Lime. And he has been a follower for me on my Twitch channel for some time. And he won a battle, or rather, I have a little a little contest before every battle that the one typing the right number gets to battle me. So that's how I choose my battler, because we are a few people there, so it's kind of hard to keep track of everybody. So he won a battle, and he won a Yu-Gi game, and we battled tons of times before. So I know that he's more, you know, synergy team, and, you know, bring a lot of fun stuff rather than bringing overpowering teams. So with that in mind, I knew I could joke around a little for myself, to be honest. So we're looking at his team here. We got, I think that is 3 UU, 1 RU, and no, 2 RU and 1 NU, and I'm actually bringing 3 UU and 3 RU. So straight off the bat, we got Zygarde, Moltres, Mega something. Oh my god, I can't remember the name. Never mind that, the Dragonfly, Electros, Mega Swampert, and Uxie. So right off the bat, we know that the Mega Swampert can be an incredible hard threat if instead of Rain Dance, but it doesn't look like it's a, you know, distinguished rain team, and Moltres definitely won't like the rain environment. So I know it isn't like a team-based or a weather team. I myself using just a little more strength, to be honest, and I wanted to utilize Beedrill, which I never done. So I'm bringing Pangoro, Hillisk, Entei, Beedrill, Togekiss, and Rhyperior. And straight off the bat, I'm feeling that my Pangoro could do well, no matter what it brings. I'm gonna expect the Uxie, but, you know, I have no idea. I'm just gonna go right on at it. So, with that in mind, guys, enjoy! So, I do the right prediction here from the get-go, and he's actually gonna start off with Uxie. And, straight off the bat, there's no reason for me not to go for a knockoff. The only thing that kinda can take it is the Swampert, if he decides to bring that in. But he'll actually bring the Zygarde, or Nagini, which is the Voldemort Snake, if I remember correctly. And yeah, I'll do some fair damage here, and I am actually forced to go for an Ice Punch instead of a Drain Punch here, because I will definitely not take it out with a Drain Punch, and I don't know how well I can deal with the damage that comes from this Pokemon. It does well over half, and even though I take down the Zygarde pretty darn early, my Pangoro is extremely limited by default, and Sparks is in the Gen Mega, and there's really nothing I can do here. I'm gonna bring Togekiss, you know, to have that. Since it stabs, it's somewhat resisted by my typing. He still breaks through and has not speed boost, has tinted lens, which means that even though that was 4 times effective or resisted, it still did roughly 20%, which is actually kind of dangerous, to be honest. And I have a tri-attack on this Togekiss. I never used one of my own. I had a tri-attack just by chance, to be honest. I have somebody wanted bread or Gen, and I've decided to keep one of my own and see if it works. Serene Race is kinda evil with Tri-Attack, it really is, with a 40% chance of effectiveness. So anyway, he's gonna go for Thunder Wave here, you know, just denting my Pangoro, really giving that nail in the coffin of what it can and cannot do. And I'm actually gonna hope for him to stay in and trying to attack me. He will attack me, but with a U-turn, which means that he's gonna leave off. And the reason that it's kind of a bad play is because I went for knockoff here, so I should definitely gone for Drain Punch and get some damage back to me, because knockoff, of course, is not as powerful when Mega Stone is in bond. So anyways, Mega Swampert's here, extremely dangerous, and when I say extremely, I mean the dangerous poke you can think of this tier. Pretty damn hard to deal with if you don't have a grass move, which I don't. And I'm basically gonna take my chance to get a free evolve to my Mega Beedrill, and I'm gonna go for a U-turn, and this is the reason you have X-Scissor on Beedrill instead of U-turn. I fall a bit short, like, not immensely short, but an X-Scissor would have finished that off. A U-turn did not, which means that this thing is not dead, and he's actually gonna set up Rain Dash, which I did not expect, since, well, since he had a Moltres and then nothing on his team really benefits Rain, and now he's able to outspeed everything on my team, and you know, we 150 base, this thing is simply too powerful. So I am forced to go back to my Singer, and I'm just gonna go back to stall out Rain for the love of God. He's going for Waterfall here, so I see this as a golden opportunity to switch out to my Illisk, which has a Dry Skin, and just soak as much as possible, hoping for him not to go for an EQ, real lucky here. So now I'm gonna expect him to go for an EQ, but he will actually switch out and go into the Anna's mouth. And yeah, that's a perfect name. anyway, so I go into my Rhyperior, and I actually get the better matchup here. I am Choice Bandit, and I'm just gonna go for Rock Blast. He's gonna go for Super Power, but with Solid Rock, that does really nothing, but it does score a crit, but it's hardly enough to take me out. I was really fearing that it was a special set because it will pack the Giga Drain, which probably would have taken me out, considered the set I am. So anyway, he's out of the way, and the crits cancel each other out, obviously. And now this thing is back in, and I have nothing that can take this properly, to be honest, so I'm just gonna leave my Rhyperior in here to die, and then bring in my Assault Vested, mind you, Entei, which is gonna play a huge role in this battle, really, really coming through here, taking the Bug Bus like a champ, or not really, but you know, good enough, I guess, and we'll retaliate with a Sacred Fire, which will be enough, of course, and basically here, I am somewhat in a bad position, of course, because there is really nothing I can do. The Swampert can't get Rain Up once again, because if it gets that, there is no way for me of stopping it. A Sacred Fire will not be enough to kill the Uxie, and he's gonna pull off a Thunder Wave here. And yeah, that is simply terrifying, because I will not show that I have Extreme Speed, but I know that's my only like real way of defeating them. Of defeating this Mega Swampert if it comes in back, of course. So anyway, I'm gonna go for Bulldoze here, hoping for him to switch out actually, because then I would actually have dented the Pokemon a little bit, or his Swampert a little bit if he decided to do so, but he will sack this thing off, and you know, that's fine, it really is. I'm gonna take that Psychic like there were nothing, and lose a little Special Defense, which obviously is not gonna matter, because, well, I can deal with that, I really can. So anyway, now the big question is, do I pull through? Do my Entei actually get to do the Extreme Speed, or will it be fully paralyzed against this beast, this monster of a poke? But Entei, you know, Gary's rank, you know, legendary dog and all, coming through and go for Extreme Speed, annihilating Mega Swampert. Man, that point was really, really scary. I would have not known what I would have done if that's the case. I actually don't get fully paralyzed any turn here, which is great, considering it's actually a 50% chance. And he's gonna go for Hidden Power, which is Hidden Power Ground, and it is Scarf, but it, sadly for him, will not be fast enough for my to outspeed my Beedrill. So that was actually an incredibly fun game, and you know, I'm really not so accustomed to UU, so I really appreciate when battlers I'm going up against actually bring in a little more of the fun stuff, and you know, just trying to make it work really. And my team was slightly more powerful, but that young Mega could actually dent me right on through, and had he pulled off Rain Dance, he probably would have won if I hadn't packed Extreme Speeders. No, in hell I would have pulled that off. So yeah, I really hope you guys like this battle, and if you do, don't forget to leave just that a like. But other than that, just to have it said, I guess, a lot of people actually mentioned that Beedrill has double the base of, or even 155-45 in base its speed, which brings it to actually a pretty scary 445 speed. But the thing is, base stats is really, you know, there's some like defined stat at number 10, which is much higher than the points thereafter. So the Mega Swampert would actually have been able to outspeed my Mega Beedrill even without that position, because my speed was 445 or in level 100, and his would be 495 versus 96. Anyway, it would definitely be enough to outspeed me, so I knew I had to stall it out. I was not faster by default and in the rain, and that's the like main issue there. Had I been fully paralyzed two times in a row, I couldn't have coped with that, so I had to yawn. I'm not gonna re-record this. But really, it really came down much closer than I looked, and I got the upper hand from the first turn, and just, it wouldn't really let off. I had just such a huge advantage, and Mega Swampert really did a number when it came in, and you know, got the momentum going for him. And really, he was not far off from actually defeating me, and like I said, one Rain Dance away was basically what it was for. So, too bad for him that he didn't have the Uxie Rain Dance. If that were the case, then they will be just GG. Like, no way I will get around it. So, anyway, guys, I hope you enjoy the spell, of course. And like I said, don't forget to leave a like. It does support me a lot, actually. And, you know, if you're new to this channel, hell, why don't you subscribe? This is a great channel. Come on, hang around there. It's a nice place. You'll love it. And, like, guys, remember, the sky is the limit. So, have a good day, guys, and take care, all right? Bye.